In topology, knot theory is the study of mathematical knots. While inspired by knots which appear in daily life in shoelaces and rope, a mathematician's knot differs in that the ends are joined together so that it cannot be undone. In mathematical language, a knot is an embedding of a circle in three-dimensional Euclidean space, R3. Two mathematical knots are equivalent if one can be transformed into the other via a deformation of R3 upon itself. These transformations correspond to manipulations of a knotted string that do not involve cutting the string or passing the string through itself. Knots can be described in various ways. Given a method of description, however, there may be more than one description that represents the same knot. For example, a common method of describing a knot is a planar diagram called a knot diagram. Any given knot can be drawn in many different ways using a knot diagram. Therefore, a fundamental problem in knot theory is determining when two descriptions represent the same knot. A complete algorithmic solution to this problem exists, which has unknown complexity. In practice, knots are often distinguished by using a knot invariant, a quantity which is the same when computed from different descriptions of a knot. Important invariants include knot polynomials, knot groups, and hyperbolic invariants. The original motivation for the founders of knot theory was to create a table of knots and links, which are knots of several components entangled with each other. Over 6 billion knots and links have been tabulated since the beginnings of knot theory in the 19th century. To gain further insight, mathematicians have generalized the knot concept in several ways. Knots can be considered in other three-dimensional spaces, and objects other than circles can be used. See knot. Higher dimensional knots are n-dimensional spheres in m-dimensional Euclidean space. History. Archaeologists have discovered that knot tying dates back to prehistoric times. Besides their uses such as recording information and tying objects together, knots have interested humans for their aesthetics and spiritual symbolism. Knots appear in various forms of Chinese artwork dating from several centuries BC. The endless knot appears in Tibetan Buddhism, while the Borromean rings have made repeated appearances in different cultures, often representing strength in unity. The Celtic monks who created the Book of Kells lavished entire pages with intricate Celtic knotwork. A mathematical theory of knots was first developed in 1771 by Alexandra Tessaphile van Diemont, who explicitly noted the importance of topological features when discussing the properties of knots related to the geometry of position. Mathematical studies of knots began in the 19th century with Gauss, who defined the linking integral. In the 1860s, Lord Kelvin's theory that atoms were knots in the ether led to Peter Guthrie Tait's creation of the first knot tables for complete classification. Tait, in 1885, published a table of knots with up to 10 crossings, and what came to be known as the Tait conjectures. This record motivated the early knot theorists, but knot theory eventually became part of the emerging subject of topology. These topologists in the early part of the 20th century, Max Dehn. This would be the main approach to knot theory until a series of breakthroughs transformed the subject. In the late 1970s, William Thurston introduced hyperbolic geometry into the study of knots with the hyperbolization theorem. Many knots were shown to be hyperbolic knots, enabling the use of geometry in defining new, powerful knot invariants. The discovery of the Jones polynomial by Vaughan Jones in 1984, and subsequent contributions from Edward Witten, Maxim Kontsevich, and others, reveal deep connections between knot theory and mathematical methods in statistical mechanics and quantum field theory. A plethora of knot invariants have been invented since then, utilizing sophisticated tools such as quantum groups and flower homology. In the last several decades of the 20th century, scientists became interested in studying physical knots in order to understand knotting phenomena in DNA and other polymers. Knot theory can be used to determine if a molecule is chiral or not. Tangles, strings with both ends fixed in place, have been effectively used in studying the action of topoisomerase on DNA. Knot theory may be crucial in the construction of quantum computers, through the model of topological quantum computation. Knot equivalence. A knot is created by beginning with a one-dimensional line segment, wrapping it around itself arbitrarily, and then fusing its two free ends together to form a closed loop. Simply, we can say a knot is an injective and continuous function with. When topologists consider knots and other entanglements such as links and braids, they consider the space surrounding the knot as a viscous fluid. If the knot can be pushed about smoothly in the fluid, without intersecting itself, to coincide with another knot, the two knots are considered equivalent. The idea of knot equivalence is to give a precise definition of when two knots should be considered the same even when positioned quite differently in space. A formal mathematical definition is that two knots are equivalent if there is an orientation preserving homeomorphism with, and this is known as an ambient isotopy. The basic problem of knot theory, the recognition problem, is determining the equivalence of two knots. Algorithms exist to solve this problem, with the first given by Wolfgang Haeken in the late 1960s. Nonetheless, these algorithms can be extremely time-consuming, and a major issue in the theory is to understand how hard this problem really is. The special case of recognizing the unknot, called the unknotting problem, is of particular interest. Knot diagrams. A useful way to visualize and manipulate knots is to project the knot onto a plane. Think of the knot casting a shadow on the wall. A small change in the direction of projection will ensure that it is one-to-one except at the double points, called crossings, where the shadow of the knot crosses itself once transversely. At each crossing, to be able to recreate the original knot, the overstrand must be distinguished from the understrand. This is often done by creating a break in the strand going underneath. The resulting diagram is an immersed plane curve with the additional data of which strand is over and which is under at each crossing. Analogously, knotted surfaces in four-space can be related to immersed surfaces in three-space. A reduced diagram is a knot diagram in which there are no reducible crossings, or in which all of the reducible crossings have been removed. Riedemeister moves in 1927, working with this diagrammatic form of knots. W. Alexander and G. B. Briggs, and independently Kurt Riedemeister, demonstrated that two knot diagrams belonging to the same knot can be related by a sequence of three kinds of moves on the diagram, shown below. These operations, now called the Riedemeister moves, are twist and untwist in either direction. Move one strand completely over another. Move a strand completely over or under a crossing. The proof that diagrams of equivalent knots are connected by Riedemeister moves relies on an analysis of what happens under the plane of projection of the movement taking one knot to another. The movement can be arranged so that almost all of the time the projection will be a knot diagram, except that finitely many times when an event or catastrophe occurs, such as when more than two strands cross at a point or multiple strands become tangent at a point. A close inspection will show that complicated events can be eliminated, leaving only the simplest events. A kink forming or being straightened out, two strands becoming tangent at a point and passing through, and three strands crossing at a point. These are precisely the Riedemeister moves. Knot invariance. A knot invariant is of quantity, that is the same for equivalent knots. For example, if the invariant is computed from a knot diagram, it should give the same value for two knot diagrams representing equivalent knots. An invariant may take the same value on two different knots, so by itself may be incapable of distinguishing all knots. An elementary invariant is tricolorability. Classical knot invariants include the knot group, which is the fundamental group of the knot complement, and the Alexander polynomial, which can be computed from the Alexander invariant, a module constructed from the infinite cyclic cover of the knot complement. In the late 20th century, invariants such as quantum knot polynomials, Vasilev invariants and hyperbolic invariants were discovered. These aforementioned invariants are only the tip of the iceberg of modern knot theory. Knot polynomials. A knot polynomial is a knot invariant that is a polynomial. Well-known examples include the Jones and Alexander polynomials, a variant of the Alexander polynomial. The Alexander-Conway polynomial is a polynomial in the variable z with integer coefficients. The Alexander-Conway polynomial is actually defined in terms of links, which consist of one or more knots entangled with each other. The concepts explained above for knots, e.g., diagrams and Riedemeister moves, also hold for links. Consider an oriented link diagram, i.e., one in which every component of the link has a preferred direction indicated by an arrow. For a given crossing of the diagram, let be the oriented link diagrams resulting from changing the diagram as indicated in the figure. The original diagram might be either or, depending on the chosen crossing's configuration. Then the Alexander-Conway polynomial is recursively defined according to the rules. The second rule is what is often referred to as a skein relation. To check that these rules give an invariant of an oriented link, one should determine that the polynomial does not change under the three Riedemeister moves. Many important knot polynomials can be defined in this way. The following is an example of a typical computation using a skein relation. It computes the Alexander-Conway polynomial of the trefoil knot. The yellow patches indicate where the relation is applied. C plus Z C equals C gives a link deformable to 1 with 0 crossings and an unknot. The unlink takes a bit of sneakiness. C plus Z C equals 0, since the first two polynomials are of the unknot and thus equal. Putting all this together will show C equals 1 plus Z equals 1 plus Z 2. Since the Alexander-Conway polynomial is a knot invariant, this shows that the trefoil is not equivalent to the unknot. So the trefoil really is knotted. The left-handed trefoil knot. The right-handed trefoil knot. Actually, there are two trefoil knots, called the right and left-handed trefoils, which are mirror images of each other. These are not equivalent to each other, meaning that they are not amphicheral. This was shown by Max Sten, before the invention of knot polynomials, using group theoretical methods. But the Alexander-Conway polynomial of each kind of trefoil will be the same, as can be seen by going through the computation above with the mirror image. The Jones polynomial can in fact distinguish between the left and right-handed trefoil knots. Hyperbolic invariants. William Thurston proved many knots are hyperbolic knots, meaning that the knot complement, i.e., the set of points of three space knot on the knot, admits a geometric structure, in particular that of hyperbolic geometry. The hyperbolic structure depends only on the knot, so any quantity computed from the hyperbolic structure is then a knot invariant. The Borromean rings are a link with the property that removing one ring unlinks the others. Snapier's cusp view. The Borromean rings complement from the perspective of an inhabitant living near the red component. Geometry lets us visualize what the inside of a knot or link complement looks like by imagining light rays as traveling along the geodesics of the geometry. An example is provided by the picture of the complement of the Borromean rings. The inhabitant of this link complement is viewing the space from near the red component. The balls in the picture are views of hollow ball neighborhoods of the link. By thickening the link in a standard way, the hollow ball neighborhoods of the link components are obtained. Even though the boundary of a neighborhood is a torus, when viewed from inside the link complement, it looks like a sphere. Each link component shows up as infinitely many spheres as there are infinitely many light rays from the observer to the link component. The fundamental parallelogram tiles both vertically and horizontally and shows how to extend the pattern of spheres infinitely. This pattern, the hollow ball pattern, is itself a useful invariant. Other hyperbolic invariants include the shape of the fundamental parallelogram, length of shortest geodesic, and volume. Modern knot and link tabulation efforts have utilized these invariants effectively. Fast computers and clever methods of obtaining these invariants make calculating these invariants, in practice, a simple task. Higher dimensions. A knot in three dimensions can be untied when placed in four-dimensional space. This is done by changing crossings. Suppose one strand is behind another as seen from a chosen point. Lift it into the fourth dimension, so there is no obstacle, then slide it forward, and drop it back, now in front. Analogies for the plane would be lifting a string up off the surface, or removing a dot from inside a circle. In fact, in four dimensions, any non-intersecting closed loop of one-dimensional string is equivalent to an unknot. First, push the loop into a three-dimensional subspace, which is always possible, though technical to explain. Knotting spheres of higher dimension. Since a knot can be considered topologically a one-dimensional sphere, the next generalization is to consider a two-dimensional sphere embedded in a four-dimensional ball. Such an embedding is unknotted if there is a homeomorphism of the four-sphere onto itself, taking the two-sphere to a standard, round, two-sphere. Suspended knots and spun knots are two typical families of such two-sphere knots. The mathematical technique called general position implies that for a given n-sphere in the m-sphere, if m is large enough, the sphere should be unknotted. In general, piecewise linear n-spheres form knots only in space, although this is no longer a requirement for smoothly knotted spheres. In fact, there are smoothly knotted spheres in 6K space, e.g., there is a smoothly knotted 3-sphere in the 6th sphere. Thus, the codimension of a smooth knot can be arbitrarily large when not fixing the dimension of the knotted sphere. However, any smooth K-sphere in an n-sphere with 2n-3k-3 greater than 0 is unknotted. The notion of a knot has further generalizations in mathematics. See knot, isotopy, classification of embeddings. Every knot in Sn is the link of a real algebraic set with isolated singularity in Rn plus 1. An n knot is a single Sn embedded in Edm. An n link is k copies of Sn embedded in Edm, where k is a natural number. Both the m equals n plus 2 case and the m greater than n plus 2 case are researched well. The n greater than 1 case has different futures from the n equals 1 case and is an exciting field. Adding knots. Two knots can be added by cutting both knots and joining the pairs of ends. The operation is called the knot sum, or sometimes the connected sum or composition of two knots. This can be formally defined as follows. Consider a planar projection of each knot and suppose these projections are disjoint. Find a rectangle in the plane where one pair of opposite sides are arcs along each knot while the rest of the rectangle is disjoint from the knots. Form a new knot by deleting the first pair of opposite sides and adjoining the other pair of opposite sides. The resulting knot is a sum of the original knots. Depending on how this is done, two different knots may result. This ambiguity in the sum can be eliminated regarding the knots is oriented, i.e., having a preferred direction of travel along the knot, and requiring the arcs of the knots in the sum are oriented consistently with the oriented boundary of the rectangle. The knot sum of oriented knots is commutative and associative. A knot is prime if it is non-trivial and cannot be written as the knot sum of two non-trivial knots. A knot that can be written as such a sum is composite. There is a prime decomposition for knots, analogous to prime and composite numbers. For oriented knots, this decomposition is also unique. Higher dimensional knots can also be added, but there are some differences. While you cannot form the unknot in three dimensions by adding two non-trivial knots, you can in higher dimensions. At least when one considers smooth knots in codimension at least 3.